it to the art dealer. My name is Jordan Simpson, and I will be talking about the artist's background, similar works, formal elements of art, and the background of Antwerp, where my artist was from. The artist who composed this piece was Franz Franken the Younger. With information given by the J. Paul Getty Museum, it helps with this bibliography, but he also was the son of Franz Franken the Elder and Elizabeth Mertens. He is a Flemish artist from Antwerp, Belgium. He was born in the year 1581, but there is no determined date on like the month or day, but he died on May 6th, 1642. A little bit of background information, his father and his uncle, Franz Franken the Elder and Harmonius the Elder, were famous painters in Antwerp as well. This is my painting. I chose this because I believe that it like speaks for itself, but at the same time, you can also have like the background of your own image of what's really going on, because not everything is being specified here. Like all these different conversations that are going on and all the thoughts in their head when they're looking at these images, it's like a picture is worth 1,000 words. That's how many things are going through all their heads. So you can just think endlessly on this image. It was also provided by the Hall Museum, but featured by Google Arts and Culture. The National Gallery of Art stated that the formal elements of art are line, shape, form, tone, texture, pattern, color, and composition. I believe that there are 4 main formal elements used in this painting, which are shapes, colors, tones, and lines. As you can tell, shapes, I think, are mostly used with the frames of the painting, so like squares, rectangles, ovals, and colors is like a goldish brown. So brown is usually mainly described as like a simplistic color. So also with the goldish kind too, I believe that it's determining wealth too. So everything inside the house, like the interior, the table, the chairs, the sculptures, and the statues kind of all portray the goldish brown color. And also their clothes. Back then, clothes were very expensive, especially to this nature, like of the poofy and like capes, the poofy pants, the long socks. These were not cheap items to buy. So the fact that the one up front has like this really elegant pink color and the cape is red, you can tell that their clothes are also very costly too. With the tone, like up here in the top left-hand corner, this is all dark. And you want to know why it's dark? Because there are absolutely no images there, no pictures, no nothing. So the artist does not want you to be looking in this corner. So I drew this diagram. It really doesn't portray the whole image. So if we go back to this, it is completely dark over here. It's because there's nothing that he wants the humans to actually, or the viewers to actually look at there. But then it starts to get light when you go across the room. And as you go across the room, there's all these images, and there's so much wealth in this room that he wants you to depict this, not this dark area up here. Then with lines, I diagrammed the lines in yellow, and I think that with this line right here, it's like forming the paintings with the frames, so it kind of creates a symmetric feeling, so you can kind of fold this painting in half and it will kind of line up. Also, the lines distinguishing the 2 different rooms. He wants you to really look at this room because of all of this, like all these costly items just within the main room, but that's probably the first room you're gonna enter when you walk in this house. He wants you to see this side room over here because look at all of these costly items as well. He wants you to think that just because this main room has so many wealthy and costly items, you're gonna see that in every room you go in. So he's giving you that depiction right there. Like the next room over has something, so the further and further you go into this house, you're gonna see costly items as well. Next, similar artworks. This is the one all the way over here on the left is an antique dealer gallery. It was painted in the year 1620. In the middle is the interior of a picture gallery painted in the year 1640. And all the way over on the left is the Poesis and Musica in a prompt camera painted in the year 1636. They are all similar to my painting by depicting all the different images, like paintings, the interior, the conversation going on within the room between all these wealthy people. And then that continued. Depictions of art with in full rooms were known as Kosterkamer. They were images that arose in Antwerp in the 17th century. As stated from Lisa Rosenthal, professor of art history at the University of Illinois, these pictures were idealized art collections as, or art collecting as an interlocking structure of social, political, and spiritual ideas. So what she's saying is when you go back to these images, you can see all these people conversating. And it's kind of interlocking society and all the political aspects of Antwerp and kind of, getting the point across of like the viewer is also sharing the same knowledge and taste that the viewer is getting and the people inside the painting are feeling too, while also showing off the wealth and development of Antwerp at the time. Also, the most common artists who depicted these the Kosterkamer images were Franz Franken the Elder, Younger, and Hermanius the Elder. And lastly, Senkovith and Von Roy from Encyclopedia Britannica state that it was considered the richest, Antwerp was considered the richest European city at the time. So they had a lot of wealth and trading, bargaining, and stuff like that. So it also assists in the second largest European city north of the Alps. So when trading, they're going to obviously use a lot of bargaining and bartering ideas. So they're going to get more paintings in and shipping out. So they're going to get money for those and more ideas when they get new paintings in. Also, artists flourished from there, most because they had a school of painting that established in the early 15th century, or the late 15th century, sorry. And because of it being so largely known, ideas were developing and just becoming new every day.